Hello, everyone. It's Rocktails Live at 505. Rocktails Live at
507.
Rocktails. I am joined, as per the huge, by Brendan J. Smith, my brother from another mother. Tricky Dicky, our producer extraordinaire. Naughty Gaudy, our director. I mean, how you doing over there? Gaudy, you doing okay? We can't hear you. I just see a thumbs up. You okay over there, bud?
Yeah.
Oh, all right, cool. Yeah, we hear you loud and clear. And on the phones, if you feel like giving us a call, you can call the Rock Line and shoot the shit with us. 855-601-ROCK.
855-601-ROCK.
The Rock Line. And Goth Gwen, who I always say she's got a cold black heart. She's basically dead inside. Shout out to you, Gwen, for manning the phones. And a little fun fact, Gwen, Naughty Gaudy, I don't know if you know this, this might come as a shock to you there, Brendan J. Smith and Richard, but Gwen is constantly reading the obits.
You mean of who died?
Yeah.
Like who died in the world?
Yeah, she checks, she showed me today, she's like, wait, you don't know about this site? Apparently, she checks. I think that's what happens if you're like a goth angel.
If you love Sisters of Mercy,
then you want to know. I mean, a lot of people died today. I learned that from TMZ.
Right, but she knows that from Goth World.
Apparently, that's a thing. You just you follow. Maybe there's like a thing you could subscribe to where it just tells you, it just texts you when someone dies.
Is there a text alert?
Yeah,
or a phone alert that you get? When someone famous dies?
It's like having a Ring camera, but for when people die.
That's right.
It like alerts your phone.
OJ.
Boom. So maybe we should start the death cam. What do you think?
What's the death cam?
Well, people that you think are going to die, just basically you staple a camera to their face.
No.
And then you catch that moment. Listen, when they're like.
I wake up every single morning.
Right.
And if I see that Ozzy Osbourne is trending on Twitter, I go into a full-blown fucking panic.
Shame on you. Don't ever say that.
Rod Stewart, Linda Ronstadt.
Do not connect.
Joe Walsh.
You're not allowed to connect heroes to death. You're not allowed to do it.
You just said you wanted a death camp on people.
Yeah, but I mean, that could be for like your grandma or something.
No. Ozzy. She's gone already.
Well, wouldn't it have been great if you could have captured that last breath?
100%.
Amazing.
And to watch her traveling through the woods behind her house with dementia at 96, knocking on doors at 4 a.m. Yeah. That would have been so much fun.
But listen, for some people, you might get lucky. You might get like that weird person that's like installs the death cam. They've like taken an air hammer. They've stapled the death cam to their head, right? It's just constantly live streaming,
yes.
Right? And then out of the corner of my eye, I just watched, Tricky Dicky just took a forward stumble up the stairs to go.
He's in a panic. Something's going on technical-wise.
Something happening in the studio.
Right.
But, again, going back to the death cam, maybe we'll get lucky to, like, someone who's like, I want to check out right now and puts peanut butter all over their face and lets, like, feral cats, eat their eyes out of their skull.
That's how I'd like to go.
Right?
What if we put a death cam on Rich and Chris Robinson tonight at the Black Crows at the Greek Theater?
That's a great idea. Because, they could have a fucking punch out and kill each other.
But they're in good terms now.
Do you think well, that's a good idea. What battling brothers should install death cams?
That's Liam and Noel Gallagher.
The next time
that they have a meeting at a lawyer's office to say, guys, here's all the money.
It's a big,
this is
giant
pile of money. You two fucking assholes.
It's seven brand new Toomey suitcases filled with British pound notes.
The king has decreed that you two fuckers are just supposed to fucking put your aside and fucking get out there and rock.
King Charles.
Look what the Black Crows are doing,
King
you assholes.
Charles, the man who touched my testicles. King Charles.
He did. Tell them that's tell the people that story quickly.
Haven't I told that story?
I don't know. We got a lot of new listeners now.
I don't know. I think I told that story. This is true. It happened in a castle in Scotland. I can tell it another day. Today we're doing a Black Crowes show.
Because we're going tonight.
We are going to the Black Crowes. They are playing at the Greek.
Yes.
I'm excited about it. I haven't seen my cousin was married to Chris.
Yes.
So that would have made him my cousin-in-law.
Yeah, what is that? Yeah, family.
Yeah.
He was an extended member of the Zappa family.
Yeah, I guess so.
Yeah, he was.
I guess so.
He was.
So I'm hoping to see cousin Chris. Cousin Chris-in-law.
Did you ever have a hang with Chris?
Oh, yeah. Did I ever hang with him?
No, bro,
Do you know how many Eggs Benedicts I had with that guy? It happened, bro. It happened. You know? I had the Eggs B. I think he had the heroin, the cocaine, and the Eggs Benedict.
Oh, allegedly.
Allegedly.
Allegedly. They broke up, I actually inherited a box of memorabilia.
Was it filled with cocaine and heroin?
Hey.
Allegedly?
There was a lot of Grateful Dead stuff.
Okay.
I got it. So in the breakup, but that's okay. But I'm going, I'm so excited because for the first time, I get to sit in the Greek theater rather than up on the hillside behind the venue.
What do you mean for the first time?
Like not the first for the time, first time. To the in Greek? A while. In a while. I mean, obviously, I've benefited from how we're getting to go to the Greek tonight.
Oh, you want to talk about that? Because we talked about it before, I think, a little bit, right? Or no, did we talk about the seating kerfuffle?
We did.
Here you go.
Are you okay, Tricky Dicky? You did stumble up the stairs. Have you been drinking a lot?
No. I just missed the third step.
Missed the third step? Because I wish there was a camera. There should be a stair cam because that was pretty funny. Allegedly.
Can I adjust your mic?
Yeah, you can adjust mine. Go ahead. There, look at that. Oh, he's producing.
Now you're probably out of focus now, too.
He's producing. All right. Okay, so context for tonight's show, right? Really excited. The second we knew that the Black Crowes were going to be playing, we were the first to get tickets.
Brendan texted me at like 7 a.m. and said, can you get the box?
Right.
And then, special box.
And then he got high. And we reminded him of this. He denied that he ever said that. Mm-hmm. Is this tracking?
Yep.
Okay.
I didn't think the box was going to come through.
When have I ever failed you?
Yeah. How about that?
I apologize. Yeah. Wow, I got
that's kind of
there.
A dick move.
I just got a little glimpse of Richard, music manager.
Yeah.
With those piercing eyes that just
when
cut
have I
right
ever
through.
Failed you?
When have I ever failed you, Scott, in contract negotiations? How dare you doubt me?
Yeah.
Wow. Right. So, okay, I doubted. So, the fact that, because I thought that the people would want to go to the Black Crowes, really, and this special box wouldn't be available.
Again, let's try to make this really clear for our listeners and our viewers. So you didn't think the box would come through?
No.
Okay. And when we said, are you going to sit with us? You said, no, because now Julia,
I had to buy tickets for me and the Hobbler.
Okay.
Yeah.
So then I called my brother-in-law, right?
Mm-hmm.
And I gave him our fourth ticket.
That's right.
For the box.
As you should have.
And then the Hobbler decided, I don't know. I don't know what's happening because you came in with a whole new look. You got a trimmed up mustache. You got trimmed up hair. So things are different with you. So I'm like, I'm wondering if you and the Hobbler, it's like some infighting. I don't know. I'm reading into this. But all of a sudden, you're like, can I please sit with you guys back in the box? The Hobbler and I don't know. Something happened. So then I had to fucking call my brother-in-law and be like, I'm sorry, bro. You can't meet my cousin. I mean, it's like it's family at this point. You know what I mean?
It's a brother-in-law and a cousin-in-law.
I want my brother-in-law to meet my cousin-in-law, and you're fucking ruining it, bro. But you know what? Because we are solid, we gave you back the seat.
I know, and I talked to your brother-in-law.
You're a real son of a bee.
I talked to your brother-in-law, and I worked my mental magic on him, too.
Yeah. So tell people how I handled this situation. Go ahead.
You left it up to us to fight it out, like two brothers who should fight it out.
I put you guys in the fucking
Thunderdome.
Yeah.
And I came out victorious.
Yeah. Doesn't surprise me.
But we both had girlfriend situations going on. He knew that. But he also, your brother-in-law also said, I can work my magic. If we want to go, I'll get there.
Does that
Brando?
Is that how TV's Patrick Muldoon sounds?
TV's Patrick Muldoon, the Malibu Sheriff.
Okay.
Dude. Very exciting.
Freeze! That surfboard's not compliant.
Dude, we fucking went to high school together, man. You can't do this. You can't snort coke at Nobu.
Freeze! Malibu Sheriff! I want to see if that cocaine smells right.
Okay, freeze. Guys, look, I'm going to drive you guys home.
How many times have I mentioned cocaine and we don't have the fucking... You're really off your game.
We're behind on cocaine.
Everyone knows the fucking rule. You mention cocaine, you do fucking shots. For all of our viewers and listeners, I'm going to do a big gulp of this delicious Austin Hope. Delicious, right?
Can I give you the quick story on the shaved head?
Yeah.
Because some of our loyal viewers like Sam and Lana, they might be wondering, Brando, what happened to your hair? Well, we've had some popular shows lately. Sebastian Bach, Tim Pierce, right? It's been popping.
Is this Brando, nicknamed Brando? He's giving us some hair news?
Jesus.
Huh. Okay.
Okay. So... I've been reading the comment sections.
Uh-huh.
And
so you read comments.
I'm just reading the comments on the shows because we've had some shows that have popped.
And you digest it.
As the kids say.
You digest it.
And here's the comment that keeps coming up again. Mm-hmm. What's Ron Jeremy doing in the studio? How come Ron Jeremy's on the show with Sebastian Bach? Mm-hmm. Who let Ron Jeremy in the studio?
I tried to defend you.
Okay, wait. So what you decided to do was to get a haircut, but keep the mustache.
But keep the boobs.
But keep anything that might really kind of link you to Ron Jeremy. So you're like, I got to solve for this. I'm going to go to Supercuts. I'm going to go to Floyd's in Silver Lake.
Floyd's on Cahuenga.
Yeah. I'm going to go to Dominique. Floyd.
Our special guest has his hand up. Dominique at Floyd's on Cahuenga.
Yeah. Yep. That's how you do
fuck.
It.
Fuck. Really?
So wait, is it problem solved?
I guess not.
Is this look Hobbler approved?
Yes.
Was she there it holding is. Her hand saying, no, you got to go harder at this?
Take I had more a commercial off the audition the other day, too, and they needed someone who didn't look like a homeless person.
This just in. Brandon J. Smith doing a lot of Zoom auditions. Maybe some in-person auditions.
This was in person at 200 South La Brea.
I mean, wow. He couldn't make our
Ross
scheduled,
Lacy casting.
Our scheduled
right, that's right.
Rock Tales
that's right.
Zoom.
That's right, because I was auditioning to be a dad, watching his wife up on a ladder, cleaning out a gutter. What, and she asked if he's paid.
Can you talk about which companies?
I can't. No, I can't because the shtick of the audition.
Just sort of make it up.
I can make it up. The shtick of the audition was dad and son watching high functioning wife up on a ladder cleaning out a gutter.
Yeah,
and it was for an app that helps you pay bills.
Okay,
and the wife looks down at her idiot husband and says, "Honey, did you pay the blankety blank bill?" And he goes, "Yeah."
Okay, wait. So hold on a second. So the premise is successful wife.
Yeah.
Right. Looking at the dumb husband. So you established that you're in your mind, you're like, I don't want to look like a homeless man anymore. But yet you're auditioning to basically be a homeless man like loser. So do you think maybe you didn't get the audition because you went to Floyd's and you look less like a porn star in captivity?
I said, I want to look like Tom Johnson from the Doobie Brothers, ultimately. Mm. Can you help me get there by cutting my hair now?
And they understood that at Floyd's? Is that how it works at Floyd's? You can be like, I want to look like this person from a late 70s album cover.
Yes.
And they'll give you the haircut?
I hope so. Because that's what I do every time.
Do they have
I go
a jukebox at Floyd's? Or?
They do. It's all hip-hop. 100% bands. Yeah, I've never. It's like the bands that perform in the Grammys.
I mean, is Floyd's a thing all over the place, or is that just an LA thing?
I think it's
as a barber.
It's out of Colorado.
Is it?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Do you go to Floyd's too?
Mm-hmm.
Wait, hold on.
Sometimes.
Okay, well,
our special guest.
We do have a special guest. I don't think anyone can hear our special guest, but they might be able to.
Look, this is Studio City Floyd's right here.
Okay.
Diane.
Wow.
Diane.
So, hey, Nesmith?
Yes, sir. Nez? Yes, sir.
Okay, so Jason Nesmith, ladies and gentlemen.
We have a camera on him, too.
He's just sitting casually. I mean, we're trying to prep for, you know, Jason, are you down to be the, you know, the house band? I mean, we've been working together for so long. Jason Nesmith, by the way, he and I did the theme song for our show. We've written a bunch of music, scored commercials, film, TV, all of that. Played in a band together for many years. Jason is, I'm going to be a little braggadocious, incredibly successful film and TV scoring, you know, musician. You've been composing and conducting as well.
Yes, this is true.
Which is awesome. And now you're just sitting on our...
Yeah, I'm here.
Leopard
I'm
chair.
Excited.
Tiger chair.
Yep.
He's playing guitar too.
Are you going to...
You can't hear it, but I am playing now.
I think you should be able to play it. Go ahead.
Yeah, play it. You're going to score anything that you think it needs scoring. Well, that's kind of cool. All right, so if I said, let's play a game where I want to set a mood, okay?
Okay.
Brando's just heard that the Hobbler, right?
No way, I got to be filled in. I think I figured out who the Hobbler is. It's got to be his girlfriend, right?
It's his lady.
Okay, yeah.
Who calls Brando Miss Brenda. So Miss Brenda, right? is in trouble. Okay, so I'm gonna set. This is happening on TV, right? Like if we're watching, like you know, on the webcam that is broadcasting live and has an official score by the legendary Jason Nesmith. You ready to do this? Okay.
So
the theme is, it's in the style of like country western disappointment music.
Oh God!
Are you ready?
I'm getting less and less ready.
So he's just been busted, cranking his dong, wearing a rock tee, right? Ooh. As the Hobbler comes busting in, he's cranking his dong to early Kate Bush music videos, right? And the Hobbler comes in to bust him, and he's like almost at climax. And again, it's the theme music, the vibe is country western disappointment. That's the vibe, okay?
Jesus. Country western, yes. Here, okay. How about something like?
You want to act this out? Do you want to act out the?
You've given him a fucking challenge.
I mean, but this is like the walk up. She's coming up the stairs, right? She knows, the Hobbler knows, because ladies have superpowers. She knows. She's opening up the door to your apartment, right? She's like, Miss Brenda, I'm here. But the fucking music is up too loud. And then bang, right through the door, and he's full fucking Jackasaurus Rex. Honestly, I don't hire Jason.
I go 80s metal. Wait, you have Jason Nesmith here. Go 80s metal.
Okay, let's. All right, we're going to give a new situation, Jason. Okay?
That was kind of scary.
Yeah. No, that was, you didn't get the gig. I didn't hire you to do the theme.
All right, next time.
But I'm going to give you a second try.
Okay.
Second try, okay? Yes.
Make it more complicated this time.
Here's the situation. Okay. Miss Brenda.
More styles in.
Okay. Miss Brenda, right, is about to be busted by the Hobbler, okay, for cooking up some meth in their Los Feliz apartment.
Allegedly.
Okay.
Allegedly.
No, this is the scene of the movie. This is the scene in the TV show. Okay, cooking meth for coyotes, feral squirrels, right? Because he's like the Dr. Doolittle drug dealer. He's like the Mr. Feelgood drug dealer for wild animals in the Los Feliz Hills, okay? Are you ready for this?
Yeah.
Okay, so again, Hobbler's walking up the steps, and this is all like 80s metal, dark metal, whatever you want to do. Set the scene. Go. Hobbler walks up the stairs. She senses something. She's sensing something. Could be wrong. Because there's like a fucking like doped up pigeon. There's like a passed out fucking squirrel. Okay, I feel it's darker. It's darker. Right? She's struggling with the keys to get into the door. Kicks open the door. there's Brendan with his pants down, jacking off to Kate Bush while cooking meth for a bunch of fucking animals. How is that metal? How is that metal? That's like the...
It's a class. It's XTC.
Yeah. Take it from the ball and chain. Take it from the ball and chain. You're fired, dude.
Damn it.
It's one of our...
Next time.
It's such a treat to have Jason here, truly. What a fucking amazing guitar.
It is.
Allegedly.
It is.
Allegedly.
Yeah.
It's only me, allegedly.
Talk about someone who knows the history of rock and roll in Los Angeles.
Is that
true?
As
you do.
Oh. What do you fucking know, J-Dog?
About what?
The history of rock and roll in Los Angeles.
I mean, are you kidding me? That's my world.
It's his world.
Give us
every fucking thing.
One story from like where you couldn't believe that you were there.
I think if I go over there, I think my cords will go weird.
Okay, your cords will go weird. Okay.
You can just take off your headphones.
Take off your headphones. Yeah. Get over here.
No one puts baby in the corner.
You want to hear, like, there's got to be a Camp Freddy night that just went sideways.
No one puts baby. Yeah, there has to be, right?
Yeah.
I mean, people don't even, most people might not even know what Camp Freddy is, but.
They should.
You know,
the Volume Maniacs need to know what Camp Freddy
is. No longer Camp Freddy, and now it's Royal Machines.
That's right.
You see.
Jason Nesmith, TV's...
Do I leave my headphones on? You'll
be all right. There's headphones down there.
Oh, right? Look at this.
It's a full-service studio, bro.
Yes.
So much equipment.
Full-service studio.
Ah.
How's that feel?
So happy.
Feels good.
Good to look into your eyes. Yes, good to look into your eyes. Welcome to the show.
Thank you. Get rid of this.
What's that?
Jesus
Christ. I don't know.
Is this... it's wireless. I did not know that.
It's a professional outfit, bro. Professional outfit.
I'm gonna score those things that you described, but I need a little
you got
more.
Fired. You're
more
not. Time. You're out. God. You're out, bro. You.
That's
you're,
it.
You're one only
chance.
Good.
One chance. This is all I get.
You're only good for other successful shows. Okay. Yeah. Not this.
Not Brando cooking up meth and beating
for wild
off
animals. Right. And yeah. Crankbass right. Dog and Kate Bush.
Give us rock and roll.
Yeah. Tell
us.
Okay. Wait. You want a story or so? Yeah. What were you gonna say? A story of something.
Well, you know, when people ask you, what's the most common story that you tell that you always know is going to be a crowd pleaser?
Whoa.
That involves you with some other famous musician where you wound up like smuggling heroin in your jacksie or something.
I do have a story of Liam Gallagher in New York.
Wait, hold on.
Buckle up.
Yes.
I want to get ready. Can you maybe cue what?
This was, I'm going to say mid-90s, 96, 97 maybe.
Okay.
At a club, I can't remember the name of the club, on 6th Avenue. We were there late night.
Okay. Were you like, oh my God, Liam Gallagher? Like, what?
Feelings. Because I had met Liam and Noel a few times before because we were in London. For years, our album, sadly, our first...
The Nancy Boy album?
I'm trying to think of which one it was. I think it was the second record.
I didn't even know you made two, because the first one was so bad.
But well, the first one was so successful that we made
the second
one.
So how many Nancy Boy records did you make?
First, we made two.
Yeah, only two. That's good. Okay, keep going.
First one was called Promosexual. Second one...
By the way, really...
Great name.
No, but super lame name.
Yeah.
But
you should have seen the cover.
But the cover is kind of awesome. You had like lights in your mouth, right?
That was for the second record.
That was a cool looking record.
And you know who shot that album cover? Stefan Sedonui.
That sounds like a chef. Video. That sounds like you hired a French culinary expert.
I think it was a woman. No, but it might have been a man. I can't remember now. It's been
Donovan at this point is dialed. Donovan
but
Leach.
He did know.
Is
he,
dialed
well,
into.
Yeah, who's
you know,
the
he
name
did
the
Red Hot Chili, Red Hot Chili Peppers video, the one where they're silver. Give it away.
That but was Stefan's. You don't know if that video. Person's a man or a woman.
I can't fucking remember. I think it was a guy. Okay. There was a lot going on in the 90s.
Well, that's for people who don't know.
I'm trying.
Let's get some background.
Say it was
a dude. You were in a band called Nancy Boy.
Yeah.
Right?
Stefan.
Who were the other people in the band?
Me, a guy named Donovan Leach, a guy named Mike Williams, and a guy named Nigel Mogg.
There's like one person who's like, finally, there's someone talking about Nancy Boys at any time.
This is maybe great. Not even right now, but maybe one will show up in a month or
but
two.
But for a white hot minute, for a white hot minute, Nancy Boy.
Not even for a white hot minute, but we made it work for a little while.
I don't need to hear the story about how you took your record advance and blew it on heroin.
Well, that's a known thing, right?
Yeah. We don't need to sell that. Now it is. It's known.
Allegedly.
Okay, all right.
But I was going to say that sadly our record came out the same day that Definitely Maybe came out.
Okay. Is that a record
in London?
That's the record that really took off. That was really big.
That was our second record, and it got a little bit overshadowed, one might say.
Right. So, did you think
In the UK, because the UK ground to a halt.
And we were in the UK when it came out. I think.
But this is like they're in the UK because they have a British bass player.
Have you seen Nigel's hair?
It's the greatest
hair. It's the best hair.
Hair in rock and roll.
Yeah, pretended to be a British band because they had one fucking...
We had two. I was actually telling the story the other day. Donovan and I wanted to start a band, but we wanted to start a British band. But we looked at each other and we said, but we're both Jews from West Hollywood. What are we going to do?
Donovan is half British.
His dad was born in Ireland. He's half Irish. He was actually born in England. That's true. But he moved here when he was very young. But so we had a problem on our hands. Okay. How are we going to be a British band when we were two American guys?
Yeah.
Well, so the way we thought we'd fix that was go to England.
Chrissy Hynde did that.
And get two English guys.
That's right.
This is a great plan.
It's a great plan.
It's a great plan.
I mean, nobody will see
through
this.
Chrissy Hynde did that.
Nobody will see through this at all. We're going to fool everybody. Mm-hmm. And Donovan was then going to sing with a slight British affectation as well, you see.
Well, that makes sense. Donovan's amazing. And I'm really not making fun of the fact that you guys made two records. I think those records are great. I love Donovan, but keep going. They're terrible. Keep going.
So we decided that's what we were going to do. So we got a little funding from our gay manager at the time.
Okay.
And he was
lovely.
Is
that relevant to the story?
What? Oh, outrageous.
I'm trying to add... elements, layers.
Okay. So layers that's relevant. To the story. Somehow,
it better
pay off.
We were called Nancy Boy.
So, okay.
Mm-hmm. That's right. And Donovan was playing with gender roles at the time.
Our first song we ever wrote, Gender Bender.
That's right. Donovan was,
this is all part of it. This sort of blurring the lines.
Yeah. Right.
Nobody knew who was doing what, that kind of thing. That was all part of the mystery.
Was that part of the shtick? Or because I want to just try to make sure shtick that you properly get canceled and no one hires you again.
But Donovan figured out, how can I safely hang with the world's top models where they won't feel threatened by me?
Brando?
I did a play with him 2 years before this.
You're right on the money.
So he was like, no,
I don't know if I like girls.
There used to be a very famous word that people would use. They don't use it anymore. It's androgynous.
Right.
Okay. And that was okay.
Yeah.
Is it still okay? I don't know. Can you say androgynous?
You just
now?
Did. I'm okay.
I mean,
with
does anybody
it.
But
he,
say
he
that?
Knew the shtick. The shtick worked.
The shtick worked. And you know who made up the shtick? Well, only one of the guys who made up the shtick was Bowie, which is who he was modeling Nancy Boy after. So Bowie was. The guy, Nancy Boy, was Bowie's little
Bowie's
brother.
Bowie's success?
And then there's Nancy Boy's success.
Bowie's success.
Come on. Ow, my shoulder.
Nancy
my shoulder.
Boy's
success.
The show at the Dragonfly. Yes, one of the greatest nights of my life.
One of the greatest nights of my life. You and me, that was it. But the two of us, we had a great time.
What you're saying is...
But it was really fun. Yeah.
So what you're saying is total authenticity. Nothing was.
Well, and so you know what? That's exactly right.
Nothing was contrived.
Everything was contrived.
Okay.
Everything.
Okay. Let's get to the Gallagher brothers.
Well, the Gallagher brothers, see, I feel like that's going to be the anticlimax story now.
Because somehow it's going to pay off the fact they had a gay manager.
I know. There's nothing to do with the gay manager. But we loved our gay manager. He was wonderful. He was he's still, to this day, our friend.
Hey, you're like, I have gay friends. I can say that.
Androgyny. He was an androgynous manager.
I get it.
Our record was out. Their record had just come out. Their record hadn't blown up yet. It was literally just out a few days.
So are you like, you're like, oh, we're kind of this. Yeah, we're Nancy Boy. I'm like, listen, brothers. Like,
Liam, let me tell you how it's going to be, buddy.
Yeah, I can't wait.
We're going to take you on tour. Mm-hmm. You know, you just be cool.
Please tell me you actually said things like that to them.
If you guys are mellow, you guys, you know, do the right thing.
Yeah.
We're gonna get you some breaks. Like,
Donovan's like, help you out. When you guys come to LA and play at the Whiskey, we got your back.
That's right. We're gonna get people there. We're gonna put you in front of people. Okay?
Donovan's like, my dad is Donovan.
That's right.
I get it. And you're like, my dad was a monkey.
Yeah, they're like,
so guys.
So Liam and Noel were like, oh shit, we better kiss up to these guys.
Yeah.
Well, first of all, they're known for that.
Oh yeah. Must have been really awkward for you guys, like, just like, back the fuck off, bros.
Maybe we'll
take you on the road, but right now, as a Jew from Hollywood, check it, babaka shabra.
And I said, listen, we're gonna have to wait and see how the record does, guys. Yeah. We're not just gonna drag you along. If you're not putting asses in seats.
Yeah. Did you get that advice from your gay manager?
Oh, we did.
We did. Pump the brakes, guys.
Yeah, we did. Oh, he was right there with us. Okay, cool. Yeah, he was helping us.
That makes sense. Okay, so Gallagher Brothers, I want to hear it.
This is what I'm saying. This story, there's really the very...
It's got a lot of beginning, a lot of middle.
A lot of
don't
middle.
Don't know if it even has an ending.
It has Zippo.
Don't even know if it's a good story.
It's not. I can tell you right now. Okay, the story dies a miserable death, only because the story is basically just that we were downstairs in a club.
And that was cool.
I tried to say hi, but the bouncer kept me from them. I was like, Liam, remember it? And I got hit in the face by the bouncer and kicked out.
That's a great story.
No. So we're sitting under the club. We're in the club is underground. We're in the basement. And we're participating, allegedly,
London. 90s London.
90s London.
Why do you have to say allegedly if you were fucking
because doing it? I don't remember. I can't recall at this time.
All right. Was it blow? Was it heroin? It was allegedly blow.
But we don't know if that is actually the thing.
We're talking about allegedly doing it or not.
God bless you, 90s London. Come on. Bring it up.
Yeah, allegedly. Oh. Jesus.
All right.
So we're sitting down there, and it was me, one other band member. It was Liam and Noel. They were both, the brothers were there, and we were sitting at the bar, and we were allegedly participating in this illicit activity. And we were talking, and things were funny, and then things started getting heated between Liam and his brother.
No.
And
you saw like a real
yes. And I watched them start to like get angry at each other, and I had no idea.
Do you know what it was about?
I can't remember. No, I can't really remember. But I remember thinking like, this is awkward, and it just...
You can't fuck Baby Spice! I'm gonna fuck Baby Spice!
Something just like that. Really? Yes. Yeah. Yes. Yes. Yeah. I don't know. But I saw
Patsy Kens at first.
Yes, that's right. But I remember thinking to myself, this isn't going to escalate. This can't go anywhere.
Uh-huh.
And I kid you fucking not, it did. They stood up. They fucking got into it. I fucking stepped back because when I see fights in bars, I run.
Yeah.
I'm not the guy that jumps in. I'm the guy that runs and hides under the under the couch.
But by the way, that's a tough move. Yeah. That's like the best way to... Be masculine and handle a situation.
And they started pushing each other, and then people got in and broke it up and everything. But I was there to actually see a real brother brawl. Yeah. And I just realized that this is very apropos of the show now, isn't it? Because we're talking about the brothers of the Black Crowes. Well, we weren't talking about the brothers.
But we are now.
Yeah.
And they did the Brotherly Love Tour, which was the last time I saw them at the Greek Theater, Oasis and Black Crowes.
Well, that's right. They did do that.
What were your seats like on that show?
Very good. Because I was doing well at that point in time. Richard, I wasn't homeless like I am now.
I could see
Chris and Rich. Chris and Rich at the side of the stage watched the entire Oasis set.
Wow.
They did.
They liked those guys. They talked about loving those dudes.
That was a thing. Mm-hmm.
But first of all, do you think that Oasis should get back together? Are you a fan?
Absolutely, they're
incredible.
I fucking love them.
Yeah,
they are amazing.
And if the Black Crowes, who we're seeing tonight, can get their shit together, right? As a great example, historically,
amazing.
Drag out fights horrible things they say about each other in the press and all of that.
This is what I've heard.
That you know, this should be, this gives me hope.
Yeah.
That Oasis.
And I have to say that, you know, these guys, they do things on their own and it's good, but it's not the same. When the magic happens, when these people get together and there is that magic.
That's right. Yeah.
Because Liam does shows on his own. I mean, he plays to, you know, gazillion fucking people.
He was on the Tonight Show
people.
Two nights ago.
And it's great.
Made
and
a record with John Squire.
I mean,
which is
right.
Of the
which
fucking,
is awesome.
Of the, the Stone Roses.
Stone Roses, exactly. Yeah, I heard some of that. I love it. It's great.
Honestly, Liam, I think has an extraordinary voice. I love that he's writing his own songs.
I agree.
I love the last three records he's made, including this last one. Songs that are real fucking bangers, right? So I'm super into, you know, Oasis getting back together. And I just think that now that Liam's had all this kind of success, like as an outsider,
on his own,
when you think about
right.
who's the main songwriter in Oasis and all of that. And the fact that, you know, his bro, like if he tries to do a show, he's playing, you know, the Chick-fil-A in, you know, San Luis
Obispo. That's what I'm saying. Noel's obviously an amazing songwriter. Yeah. But when he sings his own songs, the ones that we're used to hearing Liam sing, it's not the same. It's good.
It's
great because they're great songs. But when Liam sings the songs that Noel writes, I mean, it's fucking magic.
Yeah, but now I think Noel's kind of like,
what
Liam,
has he been doing?
Liam is more talented than Noel Gallagher's
Flying Birds. The last time I saw Liam Gallagher, last year with opening up for The Who at the Hollywood Bowl.
Yeah.
When his set started, after the first song, he had to bitch about the traffic because he got stuck on Highland.
Liam did? I love it.
Liam did. And he was subject to L.A. traffic trying to get to the bowl at 7:30.
We can all relate to that.
And he had a driver who fucked up.
Now, let me ask you this. Who was in The Who? Pete, Roger,
Pete and Roger.
Else?
And then the band is,
Jason Nesmith,
Zach Starkey,
Nigel Moggs.
We're trying to keep that under wraps.
We're announcing that too, right?
Next tour.
Yeah. Zach Starkey on drums.
Is he really?
Oh, yeah. Oh, okay. Absolutely. Pino Palladino.
I met Zach, the very first time I ever met Zach, I was at John Entwistle's house in 1991.
Who do I sound like right now, Brando?
I met Zach when I was
sounds like Ahmet Zappa, actually.
Yeah, it does. It does.
No, it's
and we were at John's house, and he was doing a studio release party at his big giant house in the Cotswolds, and it was absolutely a wonderful thing. And I met Zach at the bar.
Feel so good, Jason, to be like the son of like amazing musician. You know what I mean?
I don't know.
Doesn't it just give you the most fucking street cred? I mean, like, it's such rarefied air.
It is.
I mean,
and it's so easy to be the son.
I mean, when your dad is a monkey,
it is easy stuff. You know,
all I'm seeing is the scene of Frank and your dad on the monkeys.
Redo.
Let me put it up on the show, which is an incredible piece of television.
And the movie Head.
And the resemblance. Well, when your dad came on my dad's show, he didn't actually come on the show, but he was on the show.
When your dad came on my dad.
This is right. I know. That's what.
When that happened, I was like,
yeah, I remember that. That's why I tried to re.
There it is.
Oh, look out.
I'm Mike Nesmith, and I'm one of the monkeys. Tonight, as my guest on this wonderful television program, which has done so much for all of you young people out there, I have as my special guest none other than Frank Zappa, that world-famous person, participant in, perhaps even leader of, none other than the Mothers of Invention. And here he is. Love you, Frank Zappa.
Hi, kids. Hi, Mike.
Hi.
It's really a pleasure to be here.
It is?
Pleasure?
They have a lot of zany stuff on this program, don't you think? Well, tell me, Frank.
Tell you what, Mike?
No, you're supposed to talk like Frank. This is one of our cute numbers for the show.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I'm supposed to be you, and you're supposed to be me, right?
You see the way we work this out in advance?
Sort of how we've done here.
My dad's wearing a watch, by the way. I've never seen him actually wear a watch.
It's very difficult. I know that you used to work in Hollywood a lot.
Well, it was more of a come on, guys, let's go kind of situation.
Come on, that's like the Beach Boys.
A lot of that. We did a lot of that.
You know that after I quit the show, I'm going to join the Birds, don't you?
No, I didn't know that.
When you quit the Mothers, who are you going to join?
I may join the birds, too. I wanted to get into a very serious area that, of course, appeals to me as Frank Zappa, sometimes thought of as creative genius, especially in the area concerning your monkeys' music, which appears to me to be banal and insipid, you know?
Our music, the monkeys' music is banal and insipid.
Well, words like that are hard to read, especially side by side.
I don't think he made any fans saying that.
No.
Yeah. You know where the soul of your music was. Is it on the one and the seven? Or is it on the one and the five?
The soul of your music is on the one and the seven, sometimes on the three and the five. The soul of our music, the monkeys' music, lies somewhere in between the one and a half, the two and a half, the three and three quarters, and the giant C major chord on the piano, which I'll demonstrate for you. We have wonderful music. Match cut. Here we go. We turn over.
Okay. I mean,
Jesus.
Yeah, this is making me feel, I honestly, kind of uncomfortable. When you watch Fangs of Your Dad.
Yeah.
Certainly, I mean, honestly, we kind of, all kidding aside, right? We did have similar parents or fathers with very specific points of view.
Oh, yeah. Very specific.
Right. So, like, when people would come over, you know, Frank was so specific. And one of the things...
Everyone was terrified of my dad. I don't know, were your friends scared of your dad? Because my dad was not, especially when he was young, he was not the friendliest. Mm-hmm. He was very, very like stiff and he wanted things, and things were that way. Like you didn't step out of line in his house or do anything weird.
I
think about my kids and how my kids step and walk all over me, I'm like, why didn't I fucking pick? How didn't I pick up some of that?
I think I do the same thing. I want my kids to like me.
Right. And I think I'm overcompensating so that like I'm too nice maybe or something.
The pendulum swinging right.
It's
the other
swang
way
a little. It swang too far.
Is your wife like, you need to step up?
Yes,
and like,
yeah, all
I'm
the
like,
time.
I'm like, you want me to be the fucking hammer? Fine. Right. I'll be the fucking hammer. And
yes,
then I'm the
this
hammer.
Is my experience.
And then I'm the hammer, and they're like, "You went too far."
Right.
I'm like, "Don't unleash the beast."
Oh, 100%.
Don't.
This is 100% my thing. She's like, "No, that's. I didn't want you to scream at him. You went too far."
Do you think you and I need to go crazy into like a yurt, do therapy? Some ayahuasca, and like?
Now, have you ever done that?
No, I've never taken drugs ever.
I've never done ayahuasca either, but I've heard this is a thing.
But okay, you have allegedly
done a few other drugs. This is true.
Well, if you were to say which one is allegedly the best, what is the best alleged substance in your opinion?
Well, I'm going to have to say that allegedly I was more of a go slow guy than a go fast. So anything
I
on
know.
The slow side of things was what I
don't
what
even
I
know
like.
What the slow side of things
I like now I like massages.
Right? With a full release massage?
Like no,
a rub
you don't
and
have
tub?
To release.
Do you go on rub maps?
No, you don't have to do any of that. But like you have to just a nice massage, but I think that's a holdover from.
Is that a euphemism for
years.
Some sort of a drug? I'm like a nice massage?
It
is that what the kids say on the streets?
What I'm saying is that the massage to
so
me is
fentanyl.
Relaxing.
You're addicted to fentanyl. Is that you're openly admitting.
He's explaining the fact that he enjoys a real massage. You are trolling the valley to look for a rub and tug.
Yeah,
rub mats.
While on fentanyl, which is going to make it very hard to find because you're going to be bent over like a zombie standing there on the street staring at the sidewalk.
Yeah.
Which is what I've seen. I've seen videos
of
this.
I like it too.
Ian Asbury, do you have, do you enjoy like real massages? I'm not talking about going to the deep valley
like
for
a fentanyl foot massage, Ian.
Right. It's incredible.
Oh, thank you.
Nice. So my point is I haven't done any illegal substances in many, many years now.
Mm-hmm.
But
allegedly.
My preference has always been to relax.
Okay.
My preference has always been to feel mellow. I like feeling mellow. So that's, if that gives you an idea of what my preferences were when I was a young man in his 20s.
While he's talking about it, do you mind putting on Olivia Newton-John, the mellow track? Just so that we...
Have you ever been mellow?
Yeah, can you put that on?
As soon as that, we're waiting.
So you're... give me a situation. You're in some, like, dirty LA apartment.
Jesus.
And
reminds me of my 20s.
Right? You're by the 101 freeway.
Right. Yeah. I can hear the freeway in the near distance. The couch smells of
Melrose
urine.
Melrose and Gower at that time. Oh, that was the...
There's a fresh pungent urine smell on the couch. I'm laying there in my dirty underwear with cigarette holes.
But you're like, burns. Oh, Lane so Staley is here.
Lane, they brought...
The guy from Gobblehook is here.
Did you ever do some black tar heroin with Lane Staley?
I have a Lane Staley story, too. Oh, I'll tell you this.
I can't wait.
So
Frusciante's here.
I'm on a plane coming back from New York. And I look over, and who is sitting next to me? Not next to me, but a couple rows up. I don't know. I walk by, I see him, and it's Lane.
Because he's in first class, and you're in the back. Yeah.
That actually was true, yes. Something that had effect.
Yeah, you're like, my advance money ran out, and I spent it all.
I was in steerage, Lane was up sitting next to the pilot. Mm-hmm. And I look at Lane, and we had met because another story from years ago, but I won't go into that, where I met Lane and Jerry. But and I looked at him, and I said hello to him, and he looked
and
at me.
Just kiss me.
And
I love you.
We made out.
Oh, I'm the man in your box.
I held him.
Yeah.
He held me.
Yeah. I'm your rooster. Yeah. You want to hold onto my sweaty rooster?
Ooh, that was quick.
Yeah, right.
Ooh. When that happened.
Hey, Lane.
And I said, hey,
Nesmith, remember me?
Where are you going?
Yeah.
Are you going to L.A. with
have you ever
well?
Had
I'm
black
going
tar
there.
Chicken? It's in my pants.
It's a Cajun favorite.
I don't stuff heroin up
my jacksie.
I plunge it into my pee hole.
Yes.
You want some of this
black tar chicken playing tonight?
Suck it out.
Black tar chicken is playing at the Dragonfly.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
Black tar chicken.
There. We're going there after the crows.
Oh, my God.
Yeah. They got a late night show. So I say to Lane, I say, how's it going, man?
Yeah,
he looks at me with these eyes.
He's like, who are you?
He's like, security.
Yeah. This is fucking...
Next thing I know, I feel a forearm around my neck.
Sky waitress, this sky marshal.
I feel a forearm around my neck and a fucking zapper on my back.
Yeah.
And I woke up in L.A.
Yeah.
That's all I remember. But it was good. It was good. He was not with us. Only a few weeks later. This was right at the very end.
Oh.
He fucking killed him.
Yeah. He just said it.
There, this just in.
Goth
Quinn.
Allegedly.
This just in. News flash.
TMZ.
This just in. TV film composer Jason Nesmith openly admits on Rock Tales that he is somehow responsible
allegedly
for not saving Lane Staley's life.
You had a chance.
But no,
you
Jesus.
You could have done something. Could have been somebody.
Lane, your band is so important.
Could have been an ally, but no.
Please.
He was like, I'm in the back of the
it
plane.
It wasn't my
I'm
fault.
I'm angry that you're in the front
it
of the plane.
It was the taser in my back.
From a U.S. Marshal.
From a U.S. Marshal. I didn't know the city. That was the taser.
Yeah.
Right there. Do you got a sound of a body hitting the floor? There it is.
Yeah. Should we take a call? I don't know, should we?
Should
how about we take
call?
A break so I can pee?
Oh, yeah, see?
No,
see.
You want to take a break?
Okay, listen, we're going to take a quick
break.
And
then we'll get a call.
Yeah, we'll take a quick break. You're listening and watching Rock Tales Live at 5 with a very special guest up by the studio because we're planning on putting together a Rock Tales band, right?
We are. I've talked to some people. We're very excited.
All right, so we're going to talk more about that when we come back.
Let's do that.
Talk more about how we're excited to go to the Black Crows.
Oh, yeah.
But if you want to give us a call, please do so on the Rock Line, 855-601-ROCK. Rock Tales back in a second. Cheers.
Balls.
Harvey, want anything special for your birthday?
Just a decent cup of coffee.
You're kidding.
I'm serious. Honey, your coffee's undrinkable.
That's pretty harsh.
Well, so's your coffee. You know, the girls down at the office make better coffee on their hot plates. Well, see you later.
And he didn't even kiss me goodbye. You know, if I could just make a decent cup of coffee, I could relax. So, relax. Why don't you try Instant Folgers?
tastes good as fresh perked. Good as fresh perked? I'll surprise Harvey for his birthday tonight.
Hey, great coffee.
It's instant Folgers. Doesn't it taste good as fresh perked?
Better.
Better than those girls make at the office.
Honey, their coffee can't hold a candle to yours.
Instant Folgers taste good as fresh perked. Try it.
More drinks and more unfiltered conversation from some very uninhibited people. This is Rocktails with Ahmet Zappa.
Finally, we're back. You know, thank God, I want to just take this moment now that fucking Brando's gone. Jason's not here. Oh, he's running back, trying to plug in. We scored two more tickets to the Black Crows tonight.
We did?
We did.
No shit.
Yeah, we're going to have some of our other friends. We're trying to get two more. I really want to see my cousin, you know, tonight. Really want to lock that down.
Why don't we text TV's Patrick Muldoon?
Well, you know, he's on his own. He can get his own tickets.
Any more of that vino left? Where is that?
I can open another bottle.
Let's open another bottle. So
this is Rocktails after all.
It sure is.
This is where we drink bottles and bottles of booze.
So, Jason.
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Allegedly,
your name is Jason.
I'm scared of everything now. I got to say, allegedly, but in front of everything. I don't know. You can get in trouble for everything.
I'm picking up on the fact that you're worried.
I'm terrified.
Right? So are you up to the task of being the show band leader and playing live music?
Well, that's very questionable.
Because you know I'm going to trip you up. I'm going to get you to say things you don't
trip me up.
I'm going to ruin your life.
I think I did tonight. Did I not think of the fact that you will ask me to play every song I don't know? And I'll be standing there going,
we tried that experiment and no one's impressed. No one thinks this is a good
story
idea.
Of my life. Story of my fucking life.
So who do we have lined up? We have potentially. Who do we think is in the band? You're in the band.
I'm in the band.
What do we have a name for the?
No.
For the let's workshop it.
That's a good idea. We don't have a name. We should think of something.
So it's like the Rocktails band sounds terrible. What's the name of the?
Oh, you want something that's evocative of
catastrophe.
Like the Roots or
the Catastrophes.
Right.
Oh, I like the Catastrophes.
Because it's really what it's going to be. Every time we try
the
to play
Larchmont
something.
The Village Band.
The Hebrew Brawlers? I mean, what do we got?
I'm all with the Hebrews. Yeah. If you want to, let's go the Hebrews. But does that mean everybody in the band has to be Jewish? No, it can be me. I can be Jewish. I mean, I can be the one.
I'm open. I mean, who do we got? Who do we think we have?
Right now, we've got a wonderful drummer extraordinaire named Charles Boyd. If you're listening, Charles.
What kind of music does he play? What bands has he been in?
He's never been in a band.
Never played drums.
Okay, so this already, play drums. Just already sounds like. Is no, he just learning?
I actually haven't. Well, no, that's true. We did jam together once at Chuck Reed's house.
Okay. A friend of the show, Chuck Reed.
Yeah, and we jammed at his house. That was the only time I've ever heard him play.
Okay.
And I was. What's the expression? Two sheets to the wind?
Okay.
Yeah. Is it three sheets to the wind? How many sheets to the wind?
So,
gacked
so,
out.
So, basically, you don't know if this
no,
guy
no,
can
No, not
play.
Gacked. You can't. It wasn't gacked.
Okay.
It was like, allegedly.
Allegedly. You were relaxed.
Cocaine decision.
No.
Shit. All
right. No, we're some new reds. All here. Right. We got...
what do we got?
Rays in Hell?
Jesus.
This is cool. Okay. Look at this. Do you see that shit? It's like a skull cowboy. This is rad.
I think red wine goes with the Black Crows.
I feel like it does.
Yeah, don't you think? Yeah, now you're going to pair a wine with a rock band?
It's a Lazy Susan.
Oh, Jesus.
That's a Lazy Susan.
You don't even know how to use a Lazy Susan.
Is that enough?
Yeah, that sounds good.
I want you to be able to drive your kids properly.
Yes, no, of course. I'm going to be very mellow because I am. Yes, I have a show to go to after. I wish I was going to the Black Crows, but I did not. Know about it in time. So
okay, so I'm not impressed so far with the drummer. You were drunk and you played with him, and that's your recommendation
so far.
Oh, great.
But I think we had a really good jam. Mm-hmm. I'm going to say I think we had a good jam. You know, we'll come. What I was thinking is we would come here.
It's good.
Before the show for an hour or so and play and see and have fun. See what we play. But the thing is, we don't have a bass player yet. I was thinking.
Oh, yeah?
Who?
Young Brando?
No.
Not me.
You, sir?
What about Scott Marshall?
Who's Scott Marshall?
Yeah, sure. He wants to play. I love Scott Marshall.
Son of Gary. Bass player in Chavez.
Ooh, that's nice. Oh, wait. Say again. Sorry, what?
Scott Marshall.
Yeah.
Yeah. Son of Gary.
You think
Gary Marshall.
Of Happy Days. You guys are half degree separated growing up.
He
was in the band Chavez.
I don't want to sound like Ahmet again, but I knew Gary Marshall growing up as a child. I know I sound like Ahmet again, but I knew Gary Marshall growing up as a child as well. You know.
Yeah. Scott.
How?
Because my mother knew him very well. Not sure how. Maybe she worked on the set or something. She was involved.
Any other
photographer?
Any other ways other than the set working?
Maybe. I don't know.
Gary was happily married. I just want to throw that out there. We should do a quick tangent and say that Jason's mother, Narit, her phenomenal photography is available to see at the Halos.
You can go to halosandarrows.com. We celebrate your mom. I was just, who was I with where I was recommending that we do a celebration of your mom's work and do like a whole show? I think it was, I was talking with some of the folks at Maxfield, you know, that clothing store?
Yeah.
So your mom has some big fans over there. Your mom's incredible.
Really? Oh, that's nice to hear.
Your mom is like,
they could decorate that whole fucking place with her photos.
That would be amazing. Photos.
Come on.
Truly, she's got an incredible eye. But
she really does.
But more than that, she's an incredible woman. So sweet. Has always been so kind to, like, honestly, wild gentlemen. And I'm saying that, like, loosely. Right? Between your friends, my friends, your mom's put up with so many of us.
Oh, yeah.
So she deserves all, more credit than she gets.
Well, let's give her credit. I'm ready. To mom.
Yeah.
To mom.
Yeah, go check it out. Halosandarrows.com.
Yes, sure. Of course.
You can go there. Check out her photography.
You can go to Gene Simmons Studio Recordings. What is it?
Gene Simmons Recording Vegas.com.
Yeah. And it'll somehow get you back to Halos and Arrows for that.
But you know what's weird about photographers is that, you know, everybody now, of course, everybody has a camera on their phone. But and back then, people didn't have as many cameras, obviously, as they do now. So it was special. But even now, like, I would say in the last 10 years, when my mom would take pictures on the phone, we'd all be in the same room, we'd all be taking pictures of it, and she would take this picture that was fucking amazing, of the same thing that we all took pictures of, and it's like, it's a hard thing to kind of, it's like this intangible thing, where they see it, they compose it, they see it in a different way than your average guy just clicking away.
Is that, we see a photo in the background, Tricky Dicky's strolling around.
That's Joni and David, but she didn't take that picture. That's at Cass Elliott's house.
Right.
Mm-hmm. Is that what it says?
Well, Richard is
scrolling.
Hey,
look, there's me and my dad.
What? There's a picture of my dad right there that Nari took, a picture of you and your dad. Just go to halosandarrows.com. How about that? And just go. People can check it out. All right, so that's it. We need a bass player.
We need a bass player.
You feel like you can actually still play guitar.
Well, we're going to have to see how that all goes. I mean, you know, I was playing this afternoon at the studio, and I was doing a little
because what you played tonight was shite.
Yeah. No, well,
he was playing Van Halen.
Well,
he was playing
poorly,
AC/DC.
Poorly.
Yeah. Come on. you're gonna come here.
He keeps me on my toes. See, this is what it's you know.
But this is the fantasy, right? Is that we play the theme song live. At least you guys can land that shit.
I'll have to learn it. Yeah.
And then
here's Nareed stuff.
Yeah, look at Nareed stuff.
Yes.
The view from the canyon.
Yeah.
Someone who, the photo of Joni Mitchell. Can you click on the photo of Joni Mitchell and pull that up and make that? That is a candid photo of Joni across the street from the, next to the Laurel Canyon store.
There you go. I was
looking
wondering
across
if you could
tell. That's at Kirkwood.
Yeah, it's at Kirkwood.
It's an incredible photo.
If you know the canyon, you recognize that corner.
Immediately.
It's the fact that it was taken in that moment right there.
But she's driving a Volvo, right?
Is she? No, it looks like it
looks like a Dodge Dart.
Does it? Yeah, I can't tell on the steering wheel.
But that is, like 68? 69,
but she has
maybe?
so many great photos.
That's an insane photo.
We only have about 10 of her pictures up there. I mean, the Who's Jim
that?
Morrison.
The Jim Morrison.
I recognize that guy.
My God.
Who is that?
I don't know. I can't place him at the moment.
That's a very grumpy man right there.
That
right?
is the guy.
What's the vibe he's giving you?
Well, that's the guy that owned. He was the original owner of Ernie's on Lancashire.
I mean, this is
Mario.
A
classic. that photo.
Ernie's Taco House, yeah. That one?
Yeah. That photo's classic.
That's from Santa Monica Civic Center.
How do you know that?
Because I love this photo.
Super rare, this pic. Incredible stuff. Are we talking about the Black Crows, though, too? Okay, does she have pictures of the Black Crows?
I mean, there's no Black Crows without the doors.
They would appreciate this.
They would. They sure would.
Should we take a phone call as well? I think we have some people waiting.
Sure.
I think we should take a phone call. Spice it up. See if someone wants to say hi to Jason.
Hold on.
See if someone wants to like talk about the Black Crows.
I got to pull up the phone sheet. We have like a bajillion people trying to call in. Do we want to? Let's go to Leslie.
Hello. Go ahead.
Leslie. Is this Leslie?
Hold on just a second.
So we got something. Give us 1 second.
Give us one.
We just have to plug something back in. Tricky Dicky.
He wants to Who does so much?
Yeah.
Who does? He has to worry about 100 different buttons.
Yeah, Leslie, can you hear us? I think we can hear you now. Can you hear us?
Yeah, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Yeah. How are you?
Hey, how are you? I haven't talked to you guys for a while.
I know. It's good to hear from you. Where are you, and what are you drinking?
I'm in Austin, Texas. I'm drinking a Blue Moon.
Oh, delicious.
Yeah. I know. It's really, really good after 85-degree day, and it's only April in Texas. I'm like, oh, here we go.
You know, I'm going to be in Dallas in June.
That's too bad.
Yeah. It's going to be real hot over there.
Cool.
Right?
A little muggy.
You got to come on down to Austin.
You know,
hey, you were talking about the Oasis. You got to watch the documentary on HBO Max. It's on Max.
Uh-huh.
It's pretty good. You would like it if you like. They don't give a shit at all. They just keep talking. It's pretty funny.
I'll check it out. Sorry, what was that? I was talking over you. What was that?
You remember how we were talking a few weeks ago about you were talking about Richie Kotzen and you were saying how you thought the best singer was Ryan James Dio?
Yeah.
And he said, no, it's. And he thought it was Don Henley.
Yeah. You agree
well, now
with
it's
Richie?
Coming out that Don. No. And now it's coming out that all over. That Don Henley's lip syncing on all his tour right now. It's all over the internet. It's all over YouTube.
Just saw the Eagles.
Mm.
I didn't get that sense. I went to the show. I didn't. I feel like I can pick that stuff out.
Witchy Woman was amazing, I'm so sad right now because if he was singing to a track, I'm kind of bummed out. It was sublime.
Well, you know what's interesting? I saw Paul McCartney play, and Paul's amazing.
Yeah,
but there's something he would sing, and when his voice would get over a certain area, there was a tape that would kick in and fill in his voice. Did you notice that? You could kind of hear it. Yeah, and it's like it's just a trip.
Well,
so it's like partial singing to lip.
Here's what I'll say about it. Okay. Leslie, thank you for bringing it up because I fully expect tonight at the Black Crows that both brothers are playing the tape. They're just going to be miming everything the whole
time. That's going to be all live.
We'll get back to you on it next Friday. We'll suss it out. But
we'll be the judge.
For Don, I have to say when I saw the show, I didn't notice it, and I thought it was a great experience. Maybe they started doing it. I mean, I went to the show about a year ago, but I've seen Kiss. They say they use tapes, shows, but I think it's awesome.
It's a really interesting discussion because when you are 72 years old, right? You're in the middle of a tour. You're getting $2.5-3 million a night.
Yeah.
And you have the whole tour booked. And you're 50% the way through the tour, and you have the back nine is coming up, and your voice starts going, and you have all these promoters.
Mm-hmm.
What do you do? What's the answer?
Paul McCartney's in his 80s, right?
Yeah,
and he played a three and a half hour show.
Yeah, we'll let that go
with no breaks. I mean, he could do anything he wants.
I mean,
anything. Are you raising your hand? Absolutely amazing.
But what would you do as a, like, you guys have been touring. Yeah. You know how expensive it is. And you know if you cancel a tour halfway through.
A lot of people go down,
mm-hmm. man. A lot.
Brando, what do you got?
Yes, you in the back.
Yeah.
Can I give my Springsteen review?
Here we go.
Yes.
Absolutely.
Religious. I cried. It was amazing.
But it's all the tape.
And he was not singing,
he
too.
He nope. the whole way
No,
through.
The whole nope. thing is to tape. Whole
Hungry Heart was to tape, clearly.
But wasn't he just doing covers? And that's why
it was it? It was all 90s covers. It was so like, weird. He was
really
like Green Day,
Marcy's Playground. Doing, I like sex and
candy. I'm too sexy for my shirt. Too sexy. Yeah, it was crazy.
He pulled out some of the.
He does a take on that
did
one.
Did cranberries? Yeah, I like that.
Really?
Spider-Man.
But the Right Said Fred.
Yeah, he was crazy.
It was
killed it. It was a weird night.
I can see why you'd cry.
Springsteen at the Forum. I cried. I've seen him dozens of times, but.
Does not
sync to a track.
I give them a little bit of a break. Now, if Creed or the Counting Crows, who I don't make fun of anymore, right?
No, we've never mentioned them on the show.
I don't talk about their music as like a substance you should avoid because it might be dangerous. Right, I don't want to talk about Creed poisoning or Black Crowes, Counting Crowes poisoning, because that's I shouldn't. No one should do that and say those kinds of things. But I will say this: I would hold them to a higher standard. You know,
Creed. Well, that makes sense.
I would say, shame on you, shame on you,
Richard.
Yeah,
Jason.
Yes,
Gotti.
Yes,
someone's got a big birthday coming up.
Who?
Can we get Adam to come to the birthday?
No, I haven't taken the gummy for the show yet. No. I got to wait
second
till we
half,
get to the
second
group.
Half.
He's like, I cut my hair. I don't take gummies until 10 minutes before a situation
can
now.
Can we ask Adam Derwitz to come to the party?
Adam is emceeing it.
No. Here's what you don't know. I mean, give some goddamn fucking context so that people can follow along. All right. I'm turning
people like
50
me.
In May.
Okay? Say it isn't so.
And so, it's true. So I've been thinking about what do I want to do. I was thinking about I'm going to do a big jam with my friends. Right?
Beautiful.
And then I started thinking to my, like, that's so egotistical and that's really just for me. So I'd rather, my dear friend Jimmy, he did a really fun night where he, you know, he rented out a rehearsal space and he just did a jam with his friends just to have fun. And maybe I'll do that because I want to play some music, right?
Yeah. Jimmy Pardo's going to MC.
Oh.
Right?
Oh, yeah. He might be good. All right. Because
he'll do the crowd work.
I said it should be Patrick or Tori, but Jimmy Pardo.
Jimmy's got to do it.
Because he hates me.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, great. So here's the deal. For my 50th, This is the thinking.
Perfect. This is the announcement. He's a big announcement coming
here.
Hey, look out. Look
news
out.
Flash. Come on. Get on it.
Jesus. No. Oh, shit. Wait, there we go.
Okay, this just in.
This just in.
So I decided for my birthday, my wife has been saying, look, we want to do something, or what are we going to do? Right? And again, I thought I'd do this like rock and roll karaoke situation. But now, it's like, you know what? I want to be able to, just the fact that I'm surviving, you know, that I'm turning 50 and I'm, you know, knock on wood, healthy.
It's a big deal. It's a big deal.
I was like, I want people to absolutely eviscerate me and do a roast.
I've already written three pages.
And you,
like
you
a proper dais, you're pages. Sitting in the chair.
Yes.
Oh,
yes.
Jesus.
I've already written three
but
pages.
You know how fucking cruel and evil and mean.
Oh, yeah.
And hilarious our group of friends are.
Oh, God.
And my wife looked at me. She's like, wait, are you serious? She's holding back her delight.
This idea is genius.
And she's like, this feels right. She's like, are you sure you want to do this? What was your reaction?
Tricky about Dickie? What? About sorry, I was doing work.
Doing the roast.
Oh, I was in.
Yeah, you think it's...
I did not think you were going to say that, and that is spectacular.
Okay, you're
putting the dais together.
I was scared at first, but I will have to say this. The Hobbler pitched me the idea on my angle for the roast.
Fuck.
And I've written 3 pages.
Oh my God.
We've all started writing. And the thing about this is, Ahmet is over the top aggressive and can roast anybody at any time. But if you go after him,
I hadn't noticed.
He starts getting very sensitive.
I might cry.
And he shuts down. Oh, yeah. So this is going to be really awesome.
Yes. Yeah. Will the sisters be there?
Yeah.
Okay. My goal is a very specific.
I actually don't know. This is the thing.
Okay.
What I want is I want it to be black tie. People show up. I want good food at a minimum.
Mm-hmm.
Great cocktails.
County Crows,
which you always have at your parties.
Yeah. Yes.
Anyway,
and then I want everyone to. Fuck, it's a roast or a toast. It's up to you. I hope people really try to lean in and take me down. Gotti, what were your thoughts when you heard this, Naughty Gotti?
So excited.
So, I mean, come on. No, honestly.
He's like the Kool-Aid man. You say Naughty Gotti, he fucking comes through with an M16.
Comes through the brick wall.
On this point, Jason Nesmith, what is your first memory of young Rick Zappa or Ahmet Zappa?
Yeah.
Did you say young Rick Zappa?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think I've heard of Rick, but I don't know that I've ever met Rick.
I tried to change my name to Rick because I hate my first name.
Oh my God.
In the 80s as a young man. Yeah. Okay, so what's your first memory?
You know what? I actually have a really funny story about that because I was dating a family member of yours years ago.
Diva.
Dweezil?
He dated. Wait, you were a Nancy boy.
His name shall remain. I won't disclose his name.
Okay.
And
I think you and Dweezil actually had something. No.
I have a weird story about that, but I'm not going to say what it is right now. I have a story about it. So, no. It was, let's say, a family member removed once or twice.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And,
does it relate to anything we're seeing tonight or no?
Possibly, yes.
Yes, okay.
You dated my cousin Chris from the Black Cross?
Yes. We had matching beards. It was beautiful.
Okay.
So one day, I don't know how this is. See, I have a little bit of an issue with my memory and fucking things up based on things I don't remember.
Okay.
And.
Cocaine decision.
Cheers to that.
So she goes out and she says she's going to spend the day with you.
Mm hmm.
Now, I didn't know at the time, or at least I forgot, that she was related to you.
Okay.
I know. You have no idea where this is going. You're gonna think I'm the biggest moron in the world. Okay. She comes back.
Yeah.
And she's like, I'm like, where were you? She says, I was with Ahmet all day. And I'm like, really? Mm-hmm. So is there anything going on with you guys? Like, I started giving her shit.
Okay.
Because I thought she was dating you.
Wow.
So
suddenly it became
she looked at me like I was out of my fucking mind. She's like, are you kidding me right now? Yeah. Like, you've known Ahmet your whole life. Uh-huh. And I somehow didn't make the fucking connection. I mean, it's like, this is the weird world that I sometimes live in. It's not pretty. Yeah. And she looked at me and thought I was fucking out of my mind. And then she finally said, he's my cousin. You know that, right? And I was like, I'm so sorry.
Yeah.
I'm such an asshole.
Yeah. Yeah.
Like, I gave her like a hard questioning. What are you doing? Really? Where would you guys go? I mean, just like so far up my own ass. It was fucking brutal. That's my first memory of you as an adult.
Okay.
Because I knew you peripherally. Yeah. I knew Dweezil a little better, actually, when we were very young than you. But yeah, that was it. That's how you came back into my world.
Oh, my God.
Isn't that something? She's like, you know what? I think I'll reintroduce you to Ahmet. You'll understand.
And by the way, I was so glad the second we started hanging out, it's been nothing. I mean, we've been really fucking good friends since that
20 years
reintroduction.
Now.
Yeah. Like, legit.
I know. It's crazy.
I mean, we've never had an argument. We've only had a good time. There's still time, by the way, for us to ruin everything.
There is, of course.
Never had an argument.
Never
always had a good time. I love all of the things that we've done. We've played a bunch of shows together.
Yep.
And I really do.
And we've been in the trenches for stuff. We've been like, you know, where we're in the studio, getting notes. We've been there for hours. We're both tired. We're both short-tempered. And we still manage to get through all of that, you know.
Never. And it's been so great. And I'm actually sincerely happy to have you here, and I am looking forward to, you know, some nights we have to recognize that some nights maybe the band won't be able to kind of come together, but the notion here is we've been trying to figure this out. So yes. When is the first band? When is the band going to play?
When are we going to play?
Here.
I'm going to say
the Rocktails Band. What
the Rocktails Band.
It?
We're calling it
the Hebrew Brothers.
The Jew-brews. Jew-brews? Hebrews.
The Hebrews.
The Hebrews.
The Hebrews.
Okay, whatever you guys want to call it. Okay, I'm into it.
I like something Jewish. It's my people. I can relate to.
Okay.
I don't know for sure.
The Gefilte Fists. What do you think about that?
No, it's Gefilte Fist.
Gefilte Fisters. How about Gefilte Joe and the Fish?
Okay. I love all of
that's
this.
That's actually been used. I'm sorry. I stole that.
The Kibitz Room.
Yeah. But I'm not going to say next week.
Oh.
I'm not even going to say the week after.
So basically,
but
it's
possible.
Happening.
No. But it's possible. It could happen next week.
As a Taurus, right?
Yeah.
I really don't like getting my hopes up.
Yeah.
You
right.
Know what I mean? And I really love, you'll be here on the date that you say.
Yeah.
I really don't like the change.
I know. And the sort of the wishy-washy is guy.
I hate that.
It's terrible. I hate it too.
Yeah.
But because there are other people involved that we're gonna see. But I am excited. Let's try and do this next week.
Well.
I know
you're gonna try to do it next
week.
Well,
this is why I'm saying I don't want to, you know, the date. I don't want to commit to the date because I'm a little non-committal.
But next week is next Friday.
Yeah,
we have a band next week.
We have a band next week. We
God do? Damn it, Gotti! Right. God damn it!
All right. Well, this week has been another fabulous episode of Rock Tales.
Gotti, we are for the off kill. To.
But wait, who's the band, by the way? Are we allowed to say? Are we allowed, I don't want to blow any.
There's going to be an announcement.
Okay.
And we'll
announcement.
Get into it.
Yeah, but, of course.
Spoiler alert.
Oasis is getting back together on the show.
Jesus.
It's two brothers that fight a lot are getting back together on the
this
show.
Program.
Not bad.
Z yeah. is reforming.
Yeah. Ever heard of.
it's the 30th anniversary of Shampoo Horn?
That's right.
Music for Pets.
Oh, I got to do the whole record.
Yeah, the whole record back to front.
That would be so fun.
Oh, my God.
That would be so fucking fun.
Trickster's opening for us.
Forget about them.
It's great.
Trickster. Yeah, uh-huh. Remember them?
Yeah,
remember
Ugly Trickster. Kid Joe is playing next week.
Not bad. Not so great.
Yeah, from the Sunset Strip, it's Shell Shock.
All right, so we are excited. Thank you for watching and listening to another episode of Rock Tales. Jason Nesmith, my other brother from another mother.
Yes.
Love you.
Love you
the
too,
whole
buddy.
Family,
love
your
you
wife,
too.
Your kids, your
same.
Beautiful boys.
Same.
To everyone out there, we'll see you next week. We're going to try to pull off another live show. Thank you so much for tuning in. We're going to the Black Crowes. We will give you our review next week. We will hopefully have some live music. Lots more fun. The summer's coming. We're doing so many great things. See you next week.